Sam Larner of Winterton, Norfolk. At 84, still able in his songs to recapture the tang of life as a herring fisherman. Sam remembers the days of sail, but his songs are older yet, in the folk tradition born of a working life in the open air. Harry Cox is a man of the land, a farm worker of Catfield, Norfolk. At 78, he works and sings to the old rhythms of life before the combine harvester. These two men speak for an England that has passed and yet lives robustly in their songs. And if we've the patience to listen, then like a whole camera crew, we can be brought into a rich fellowship with that past.
Windy old weather, squally old weather, when the wind blow, we'll all go together. Then up jumped the codfish with his great old head. He jumped on the foredeck to get a cast of lead, singing windy old weather, squally old weather, when the wind blow, we'll all go together. Then up jerked the roker so sharp and so rough. He said to the cook, you are burning the duff. See after it, you bugger, see after it, you bugger, when the wind blow, we'll all go together. Then up jumped the herring, the king of the sea. He said to the skipper, look under your lee, singing windy old weather, squally old weather, when the wind blow, we'll all go together. Then up jumped the spret, he's the smallest of them all. He said to the skipper, all the minstrel, singing windy old weather, squally old weather, when the wind blow, we'll all go together.
Sam, can you tell me a bit about Winterton as a boy? Were all the boys at sea?
Oh, yes. That was about, when I was a boy, I reckon there was about 200 men and boys out of this village then. But in 1900, I think there was 320 or 30.
And you spent all your life at sea?
Oh, yes. I went to sea in 1892. That's when I first went to sea. That's 71 years ago, ain't it? 71 years, is it?
And when did you leave the sea?
When I leave the sea? When I was 56. I had to give up. I went to the hospital, Norwich Hospital, and I was all, he said I'd pulled too much, pulling that strain to all the lower part on me, you know, because that's hard work at sea, you know. I said, that consisted often of pulling. He said, oh, he said, well, he said, that's what's the matter, you pull yourself.
But Sam, the herring season doesn't last all the year round, does it?
Oh, no, well, you go down to the Shetlands. Now, we used to go down to the Shetlands, then come up as far as Shields, have a little touch there, then have a touch in Scarborough, then come home, then make up and then go down to Grimsby for a little while just before the home fishing. Then we used to finish on the home voyage up Christmas.
Now, Sam, will you sing me the Dewy Morning, which you know is a song I like?
Yes, I'll sing it to you. I read it for it. Would you like to hear it? As I walked out one morning gay to see what I could shoot, I there espied a pretty fair maid come tripling by the road. So all hail the dewy morning, blow on the wind, I owe, clear away the morning dew, how sweet the winds do blow. We both jogged on together till we came to some locks of bay. She said, young men, there is a place where you and I can lay. So all hail the dewy morning, blow on the wind, I owe, clear away the morning dew, how sweet the winds do blow. I put my arms around her waist and I tried to throw her down. She said, young men, the dewy grass will crumple my silk gown. So all hail the dewy morning, blow on the wind, I owe, Clear away the morning dew, my sweet, the winds do blow. She said, you can come to my mother's house, there you can lay me down. Take away my maidenhead, likewise £1,000. So all hail the dewy morning, blow on the winds, I owe. Clear away the morning dew, how sweet the winds do blow. I took her to her mother's house, and she quickly locked me out. She said, young man, I'm a maid within, and you're a fool without. So all hail the dewy morning, blow on the winds, I owe. Clear away the morning dew, how sweet the winds do blow.
I've never seen a thing like this before in my life. What do you call him?
I call it Dancing Doll.
And where does he come from?
Well, I made myself.
Now, is the sort of dancing he does the dancing that would have been done around here?
Oh, there's a lot of that done in the pubs. I was born 1885. And I've been knocking about on the lane ever since I was able to do anything. My father, he didn't stick the lane like I done. He went on the fishing and on where. He done all sorts, he did. He won't go up a tie to this lot like I was. Pay was very low, 10 bar a week. I knew him to get 9. 13 in the family. 9 bar a week I remember to get. In my time. He couldn't swallow that. I don't know who could. They were the times they were. We'd no Sunday suits, nothing. We went about just anyhow. You were lucky to have a shoe on your foot at all. When play on his head, you'd head off, Bigby, what alone? That was a life. That's how it was in my time, in a case. As I walked out one May morning, so early, I overtook a fair young maid just as the day was dawning with my dear and a feather a little I-O. Her shoes were black, her stockings white, and her buckles shone like silver. She had a dark and rolling eye, and I hung down her back with my dear and a feather a little I-O. How old are you, my pretty fair maid? How old are you, my honey? She answered me quite cheerfully, I am 17 come Sunday with my dear and a feather a love, feather a little I-O. I said, my dear, will you love me? Will you love me, my honey? She answered me quite cheerfully, I dare not for my mammy with my dear and a feather a little I-O. If you come round to a mamma's house when the moon shine bright and clearly, I will come down and let you in, so my mamma shall not hear you with my dear and a feather a little feather a little I-O. I did go round to her mamma's house just as the moon was dawning. She did come down and let me in, and she laid in her arms till the morning with my dear and a feather a little feather a little I-O. She said, my dear, will you marry me? It's now your chance, no never. And if you do not marry me, then I'm undone forever with my dear Amada. Feather it love, feather a little I owe. The pipes and drums of my delight is through the woods we ramble. The pipes and drums are my delight, and I'm happy with my soldier, with my dear Amada. Feather it love, feather a little I owe.
Did you go to school as a boy, Harry?
I went, we never went until we were six. We went when we were 6 years old, and then we had to pay twopence a week. You had to pay twopence to go to school that time of day. And we paid, she paid, there was six went, and she couldn't stand it. Couldn't pay it. She earned a lot, about 10 bob. So she got out of that, they paid the old ladies, Barton Hall, I think, paid for her then. Wouldn't pay that amount.
But how did you get on at school?
Poor, I never learned nothing. You didn't try. I never learned anything there. I learned 10,000 times more since I left. I learned myself. I was no one to read and nothing like that. Well, I can read now. I learned myself. I learned more since I left than I did when I went.
And when did you leave? What age were you?
About 12 and a half. And I've been not ever since. Never knew what was to have any illness and that sort of thing. I've been going over all the time.
When I first went, that was poor doing when I first went to sea, you know, and in 1892, when I first went to sea, that was poor doing then. I was a whole North Sea and fishing for £5. That's all I got, £5.
How long was that?
Well, about 20 weeks.
£5?
Yes.
All the way?
Cabin boy, 20 years, that's all I got. Poor, things were poor then, we were poor as church mice. Do you know that's how that was that time of the day, yes.
Now, did they ever sing in the streets, the fishermen, when times are hard?
Yes, I tell you, in 1894, there was a big fishing. And they had enough to have a bulls up. And they got a banner and rugged it up. And they carried it in front, and they sung this. A penny towards the pot, my boy is a penny towards the pot. There's a bit, the Steve-O will not break you, the cases you have got. That's what they sung to go and get some beer. Went round the village. And I always say that I was about 9 years old then.
What's a Steve-O?
A penny. Penny, that's what they called a Steve, a penny.
Now, Sam, these songs, that song would have been made up by the fishermen, wouldn't it?
Oh, yes, they made that up themselves, to go round, you see. A penny towards the pot, my boys, a penny towards the pot.
These songs of yours, Harry, where did you learn them?
Well, songs I learned anywhere, over different people. And I started learning songs when I was about 11 or 12, picking up pieces. And I kept going on, like that's where I knew them.
But were they a tradition in your family? Did your father sing?
Yes, more for the father and mother. I all knew the songs, I know bits of all.
And what sort of songs have these been? You said your father was at sea. Would these have been sea songs?
Yes, he learnt sea songs and all sorts of songs when he was there. This is one he used to sing. So come all you brave young seamen, bold that plough the raging sea. Come listen to my tragedy, I will relate to thee. When pressed I was from my own true love, she was the girl that I adore. And pressed I was to the raging seas where the foaming billows roar. Sometimes on deck, sometimes alone, and oftentimes below. When the thoughts of folly came into my mind, when the stormy winds did blow.
Now, I always was a singer, though I had to boast myself, but I always could sing a song, because I was in the choir, the church choir, 20 years. and I was always picked out. When we went festivals, I used to be picked out all the part singers. My little tenor voice used to always go in all of them to sing. Yes, I always went there and all of them. They picked me out.
And when you'd learnt them, Sam, when did you used to sing them?
In the pubs. Mm-hmm. Well, you could hear a pin drop when I used to sing. If them youngers had made a noise when I started to sing them songs, they'd throw them out of the pub. Yes. They used to have a song and a four-handed reel and a song again and all that sort of thing. See, there was no pictures or nothing that then. There was only just a train to go to Yarmouth with. That's all you had to go to your boat. Well, there was nothing there. Only they made the moves upon themselves. See, that's how that was done years ago.
How about when you're at sea?
Well, you used to sing when you're old and you used to sing. When that's what that come in, you see. When the wind blow, we'll all pull together. See, when she roll, when you're getting a big shimmer of herring, there's a lot of weight. Well, when she go to the nets, when she roll the nets, oh, you give them a drag in, you see, that help you. The boat are rolling towards the nets, well, that help you to get your nets in better like that.
What do you mean by a shimmer, Sam?
That's a small shimmer. A big shimmer, though, that's 100 crown, we'd call that a big shimmer.
In fair London town, a young damsel did dwell, wit and her booty, none could her excel. Her wit and her booty, none could her excel, and her husband, he was a bold drover, feller and her light day. A groggy old tailor, he lived close by, and all on this fair damsel he cast a sly eye. 10 guineas I'll give if I can with you lay, your husband he is a bold drover, feller at their light eye. The bargain was made, and upstairs went straightway. They hopped into bed, soon the music did play. They huddled, they cuddled, they both fell asleep, and they never once thought of the drover, feller at Lurley Day. In the middle of the night, the old drover came home. He knocked at the door with the palm of his hand. Oh, hide me, old tailor, he cried, but I heard the loud knock of the drover, feller at Lurley Day. There's a rustic old cupboard hangs over the door, where you can get in so snug and secure. I will go down and I'll undo the door, and I'll let in my husband the drover, feller at Lurley Day. She undone the door and her husband walked in, with a kiss and a compliment she welcomed him in. Your kiss and your compliments, I don't give a pin, I will strike up a light, said the drover, feller at Lurley Day. Oh, husband, dear husband, there's no fire stuff, if you come to bed, you'll be quite warm enough. The rustic old cupboard hangs over the door, and this night I will bounce at the drover, feller at Lurley Day. He knocked this old cupboard, went down on the floor. He kicked it, he knocked it, well, all or in all. Here's over lugs and right out of the door, and away run the groggy old tailor, feller at Lurley Day.
Did you ever learn any songs from music, from sheet music?
No, I learned the Mignonette, I know Mignonette, I know that one, and you know Mignonette go, don't you? You heard of Mignonette, don't you? You do, don't you?
Well, let's hear it anyway.
Mignonette, yes. Goodbye, Mignonette, don't forget I love you yet. If you should want a friend, that friend am I. Farewell, little girl, far away I mean to dwell. Kiss me, you won't, ah well. Mignonette, goodbye. Mignonette, goodbye. I used to sing that. They were crazy when that first came out. I learned it, you know, and I picked it up. And I used to sing that, but way, they wouldn't let me rest. Come on, let's have Mignonette. They'd said that I used to go in the pub.
But these aren't really the old songs, are they, Sam?
No, they aren't. No, they aren't the old songs. They aren't, no.
They were the sort of pop songs of the
day. That's right, yes, that's right.
But you like them as well as the old ones?
Oh, I like that. There's some I didn't like, but they were that Mignonette one, a bad song. Mother's baby, I love your sweet peach. Baby, my baby, 'tis the courting season, so I sees no reason why you won't come and take a walk with your boy. Who's that nigger singing songs last night under your window? Perhaps he's a better looking girl than I. If so, well, I'll go right now. That's how that went. A lovely old song, that was. Well, they thought the world of these chaps about here, you know.
One morning in the month of May, as from my cot I stray, just as the dawning of the day, I met with a charming maid. My pretty maid, now whither you stray, so early tell me now. The maid replied, kind sir, she cried, I have lost my spotted cow. Oh, no longer fret, no longer mourn, your cow is not lost, my dear. I saw her down in yonder grove. Come, love, and I'll show you where. I must confess you very kind, very kind, said she. It's there you're sure the cow to find. Come, sweetheart, walk with me. So if I should cross the farmer's glen, or go and view the plough, she'd come and call the gentle swain, I have lost my spotted cow.
Sam, what's the song you like best of all?
What's the song I like best of all? Well, the best one I always did like was Inner Martin, that's a good song, that is. And that was a true, and that's one of the oldest old folk songs there is in history, that one is. Inner Martin. They come right from Scandinavia, right down from the Scandinavia, that do.
Now, where did you learn that?
It's sea. There's an old chap used to sing it about Anne. His name is Sutton. Locke called my nickname. He used to sing them songs. And he'd sing this one. What is it? Why, wish I got killed on the banks of the Nile just before the daylight in the morning. For to kindle a fire, it is my first job. And if I don't do it, there's a smack on the gob. And a hit or a kick or a smack on the gob, I surely would get from my darling. She'd a beard on her lip like a wandering Jew, not a tooth in her head that was sound all but two. A smock she had on was neither black night nor blue. It had never been wet with the washing.
Now, Harry, these were songs in the pubs for entertainment. Did you ever sing around the farm when you were working?
Yes, you used to sing. You got a nice job. You could sing all day long, move yourself. I sung horse, no horse.
And what sort of songs would you sing then?
Well, anything come to mind, like this there one. 'Tis of a young squire in Bristol did dwell, and ladies of honour, they loved him well. But it was in vain it was said, that he was in love with the bonnie milkmaid. The squire and his sisters all sat in the hall, and as they sat talking, they heard someone call. And as they were singing the sweet morning song, Pretty Betsy, the milkmaid, came tripping along. That's the sort of song that I used to sing. Anything come into mind?
I've been a wild rover for many long years. I've spent all my money on wine, ale and beer. Now to give up all roving, put my money in store. And now will I play the wild rover no more. Nay, no, never, never no more. Now will I play the wild rover no more. I went into an alehouse where I used to frequent, and told the landlady my money was all spent. I called for a pint, but she says to me, nay, such customer as you I can meet every day. Nay, no, never, never no more. Now will I play the wild rover no more. I put my hand in my pocket, drew handfuls of gold, and on the round table it glittered and rolled. Now here's my best brandies, my whiskey and all. Be gone, landlady, I'll have none at all. Nay, no, never, never no more. Now will I play the wild rover no more. I'll go home to my parents, tell them what I've done, and ask to give pardon to a prodigal son. And if they forgive me, which they've done times before, then now will I play the wild rover no more. Nay, no, never, never no more. Now will I play the wild rover no more. Oh, broadside, to broadside, these two vessels did lay. They were fighting for hours or more, till at length Henry Martin gave her a broadside, and she sank, and she never rose more. Sad news I've to tell you, sad news I've to tell. Bad news I'm a-going to tell. Off aloft a tall ship, lost on the salt sea, and the most of our mariners drowned. As I walked over London Bridge one midsummer morning early, there I beheld a
Hey, fair lady, lamenting for a Georgie, I pray can you find me a little boy who can go an errand swiftly, who can go 10 miles in one hour with a letter for a lady. Now come saddle me my best black horse, come saddle it quite swiftly, that I may ride to the king's castle gold and beg the life of my Georgie. So when she got to the castle door, the prisoners stood many, they all stood round with the caps.